10:30 p.m. We set up from the hotel at 10:30 a.m. A team of American, three Americans and a Micra. They started their trip, but they didn't have the paperwork to say they owned the car.
Yeah,
what time is it? You're on.
He's very famous down under.
I've got a show. Like, I'm gonna get up there to Channel 10. Maybe get a stint.
So it is 12:30, and we are still at port. We'll sleep in the cars, I'll sleep just outside and await word. We're really at the mercy of whoever comes and sees us because we don't speak the local language. Nathan had a few run-ins with losing the guy's ball. When we went and played soccer in one of the abandoned ships, which was actually really awesome, but the day has been very big.
So it's 3 a.m. We've been working up to try and get on this ferry, and everyone's gone to get their passport stamped. But in the process, we realised we've somehow misplaced the micro keys just before we went to sleep. So everyone's frantically searching around for them. If we can't find these, we are pretty much fucked because we haven't got any spares.
Oh no!
Yeah. All right, so panic attack over, found the keys, some dickhead hit him when he was half asleep under the visor, and it was the last place, literally the last place we looked. So as the funnel master, I self-allocate 5 funnels.
Oh, I can't wait.
To myself. One for every member of the team that I stressed out. So we're all just really thankful we found the keys because it was really stressful. But as you can see behind me, there's a whole series of teams that have already driven onto the ferry, and we were quickly looking at a point where we're trying to hot wire and brake steering lock and piss around. So, boys, I'm sorry for the stress I've caused you. I love you.
Yeah, we're hoping in maybe the next 2 or 3 hours they'll let us out. This kind of just shows you what the trip's just been like, just disorder, and really us just banded together trying to make it bearable. We've got quite a few good lads, which has made it a bit easier. But geez, yeah, if you did this on your own, yeah, I don't know how you do it. Also, we want to apologise. A couple of days of footage that we got on the ship. Richard's microphone is a bit busted, so we've just got static, so you'll be able to see the images, but you just won't be able to hear the audio, which is unfortunate, because we had a few interviews from some of the other lads in the team, so. But hey, you've got to do what you got to do. A couple of the lads driving in the red fire truck you see behind me have had a bit of an issue with their radiator. Initially they were getting blocked up by the bumper not allowing enough airflow through, and they overheated a couple of times. We've managed to cut a bit of that away, but it's left it exposed and a rock's gone straight through the middle of it, bursting one of the vanes.
Kindly helped by the Aussie fellas. They took us under their big Aussie wing, so to speak. And as down payment for getting across the border, I'm having to get my head turned into a salad. The deal is, I'll get mine done now as a down payment, and then when we get across the border, which is probably going to be a while now because the road has turned to shit, as you can see by these guys having to reattach their sump guard.
Stuck at some blockade, we don't even know if it's legitimate yet, on our way to Bukhara. We were making good ground. The Jimny's running a bit low on petrol, and we've gone past about 10 to 12 different petrol stations, all of them just purely propane gas. So Uzbekistan is obviously abundant in gas, and no one drives petrol cars. So we're getting nervously low.
We're somewhere in the Uzbekistani desert. Our lovely fuel-guzzling Jimny has run out of fuel. We kind of got ourselves caught in a very interesting position where, you know, we'd speak to some locals and they were like, fuel 10k, so we said, okay, 10 more k's, and then it kind of seemed to revolve a few times until we got to a point where there was just no fuel. Most of the fuel stops we tried to go to were just bowsers with no people or only sell propane, and it was really weird. So we slipstreamed for about 100 kilometers. I was driving about 1 meter from the micro's bumper, which is pretty fun.
Okay, so today's day 437. We've just left our little camping spot on the side of the road on the way to Bukhara. We were very fortunate to actually have a few of the Mongol Rally has come past us last night. Charitably donate 10 litres of fuel to get the Suzuki to hopefully to Gaza.
Blackmail.
And we had a nice little look at the town, caught some whiffy, caught up with lots of other ralliers, and actually caught up with a couple of ladies whose van had broken down, much like all of that tour. And so, in the kindness of our hearts, we're going to tow them half the way there to summer camp.
So we towed these girls from Bukhara to Samarkand.
About 300 k's.
It was about 300 k's. We drove from 6 to 2. I'm no mathematician, but that's about 7 hours. Yeah, fuel in this country is very difficult to find. Last time we purchased a bunch of fuel out of some guy's shed. He basically went to the bowser in the morning, bought it for a dollar and sold it to us for $1.50 or something like that.
As of last night, we stayed at a lovely little hotel. We cooked up some mean noodles and refreshed ourselves for a big crack at the premieres today.
We are in Tajikistan. Gonna climb some mountains. We're really impressed. The guy seems to indicate that we can get fuel a lot more easily than we could in Uzbekistan, which is a pain in the nuss. We finally found some benzene. Woo! So we get drunk. So while we smoke weed. We're just having fun. We don't care who sees.
So while we go out. So we've managed to find a local guy who said he's willing to do some welding for us because the bash plates that are giving us a bit of grief, and we asked the price and the guy said he didn't want anything, so we've been pretty overwhelmed with the hospitality of the people from Tajikistan so far, so very thankful, very appreciative. So this guy's going to get a big hug from Richie. You know they're good.
Let's do it. To the stingers. You a class clown, and if I skip for the damn with your bitch smoking gray,
you know what? It's like I'm 17 again, peach fuzz on my face, looking on the case, trying to find a hella taste. Oh my God, I'm on the chase, Chevy, it's getting kind of heavy, irrelevant, selling it, dipping away, time keeps slipping away, zipping the safe, flipping for pay, tipping like I'm dripping in paint, up front, four blunts like Khalifa, put the wheat in
so
the jar.
So what, we get drunk, so what, we smoke weed. We're just having fun, we don't care who sees.
Introduce yourself.
Hello, I'm Harry, you guys are going to swim to Afghanistan.
Right now as we drive, we are tickling the border between Tajikistan and Afghanistan. In case Bucky will happen to point out for you, we just have that, you can see some of any houses. So basically on the other side of the river.
It appears from the flags that it links both Tajikistan and the Afghan border. So it's closed at the moment for obvious reasons, but we just thought the contrast was quite... It appears I've also been abandoned. I may have to sell myself in Afghanistan to get home.
No children, had a size project, me and Matt killed it.
THC, MAC, DEV, HD3, hi, it's me, this is us. We gon' fuss and we gon' fight and we gon' roll and live
on. So what, we get drunk. So what, we smoke weed. We're just having fun. We don't care who sees. So what, we go out. That's how it's supposed to be. Living young and wild and free.
Yeah, roll one, smoke one. When you live like this, you're supposed to party.
We're just leaving Korog and we're going to start the proper Pamir Highway where we're going to climb to something near 4,600 meters.
Like this, you're supposed to party. Roll one, smoke one, and we all just having fun.
So up we get drunk, so up we smoke weed. We're just having fun.
So I've just been told, 4,250 meters above sea level and 10 degrees Celsius. We all got our clothes on, going past another Mongol team.
What's the best thing you've seen so far?
You guys.
Stop it.
We have completely broken roof racks, as
okay.
You can see, if Nathan showed.
Okay, yep, sorry.
So we're transferring them to the micro. And that's it.
I don't think it's that bad. I think some duct tape and WD-40 will fix that shit straight up. Neindorf is looking partial Viking over here with some animal on his head.
Do you have any gripes following the second failure?
I didn't catch that little marble thing. I had to run across the desert trying to find it. Fast around the little bowl. Describe it for the good people.
So what did they look like, these little animals?
It's like a beaver.
I've just done a check on my penis to get an idea of how cold it is, and my penis has turned into a belly button, so I think it's quite cold.
Desert sun, my skin began to turn red. After 3 days in the desert fun, I was looking at a riverbed. And the story it told of a river that flowed.
We've climbed the Caracol Pass, which is 4,700 meters, 4,300 meters, sorry, not that anyway. And we're on the Pamir Plateau, but it's not all been smooth sailing. We've somehow completely busted the rear left spring in the jimmy, which I can't believe it actually happened. And we've ripped the rear bumper off the white truck.
After 9 days, I let the horse run.
quite expensive.
The ocean is a desert with its life underground and the perfect disguise above. Under the city lies a dark made of brown, but the humans will give no love.
No, fuck off.
So Rich, is there anything you want to say in your defense as to your current predicament?
Yeah, your jacket doesn't match your pants.
Is there anything relevant you want to say about this predicament?
I did indicate, should we really do this twice, and whether or not we get bogged, and oh boy, are we bogged.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For no real reason.
Alrighty, so we just set up camp for the night. We've found a better place than the one before, so we're going to have a nice do it. The boys have done a fantastic job, but...
And check it out.
Oh, it's
nice.
Thanks, mate.
What a top line.
Yeah.
Alrighty, so it's the morning of day 29. We've camped up last night. We're about 10k's out of town doing the Pamir Highway. And god damn, it was cold last night. Holy hell. We all woke up having to put either extra jumpers, beanies, socks, another layer of pants, or something stupid on. Shane Garrett with his flute suit. Nothing but confident. Gotta respect that guy. Even he was cold in that thing.
He's got clothes on underneath the flute suit, which is unheard of.
I'll take it in, but don't look down. 'Cause I'm on top of the world, eh? I'm on top of the world, eh? Waiting on this for a while now. Paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile, eh? Been holding it in for a while, eh? Take you with me if I can. Been dreaming of this since a child. I'm on top of the world. I've tried to cut these corners.
So our mate Big Jamie Trainer has been pretty crook.
Yeah, squid down.
Yeah. So yeah, he's walking back pretty slowly now, but we're hoping it's altitude sickness and it's not anything related to food. Because yeah. If we drop the altitude soon enough, he should start feeling a bit better.
Finally, can't wait to get out of the shithole. But it is the home of Bora. Nana!
Alrighty, so we've been forced to pull over and camp up for the night in the cars. Absolutely nowhere to pull off and pack tents. We're about 20 or 30 k's out of Usharal. Which isn't ideal, although we've taken a chunk out of Kazakhstan, about 750 k's. We're hoping to drive all the way through, but the micro's forced us to pull over with its second flat tire.
The roads here are absolutely horrendous, so that's absolutely why the tire shredded. 3 or 4 hours sleep and we get into it. Earlier tonight we got pulled over by the cops for going down a one-way street the wrong direction. We literally did it right in front of the cops.
Right in front of them. Yeah. I don't know whose fault that was.
It was a shared effort, I think. we'll share that one. But the cop was really, really aggressive and a bit of a wanker. and then Nathan and I started talking to him, saying I'm sorry, and ended up singing to this guy and his mate, and they ended up in tears laughing. So I think a bit of humour goes a long way in stressful situations. So we managed to get off without a fine and just a bit of comedy. So.
Morning, boys. Let's hit it. Mongolia, baby. Woo!
All right, P-Mac. Last quarter, mate. Ooh,
yeah.
How's it feel?
Fucking amazing. Last quarter, so Mongolia. We're done.
Richard, what's your name?
My name is Richard.
Okay, good.
Yes.
And the nine door strikes again with another flat tire. So.
A little taste of the Mongolian northern route. I'd like to show the head into a barbed wire fence, but you'd probably tell me all about it. You shit me to tears.
Shano is about to present this young Mongolian boy with a kangaroo.
A kangaroo. I love you, Rich.
I'm going to turn the camera off before Nathan does something silly. Oh, it's happening.
Close to tragedy, close to folks you have. Welcome to Mongolia. Welcome to the boys. I'm not really sure if there are any road rules here. I'm making the judgment that there's not. We've got these kind of conditions here. Nindorf's got to straddle the edges. One wheel on the berm, the other. And we don't have a spare. So we're taking it very grizzly. So Shane, the Nindorf strikes again.
Yes, this is another episode of
Nindorf ruins the car.
Ruins things on this car. Just this car particularly.
This car particularly. He's got no respect for it.
He's now down to.
He's down to, I think, four wheels broken.
Now
one bumper. What do you think of that? Our bumper is being donated to the Mongolian desert. I hear it's biodegradable. Don't check. I'm not a coward, I've just never been tested. I'd like to think that if I was, I would pass. Look at the tested and prepare before the grace go on. Might be a coward, I'm afraid of what I might find out. If I could, it makes me wonder if I
man spider. Hopefully we don't have to use it.
So it's our last night before we land and finish in Ulaanbaatar. Mongol Rally nearly finished. So we're cooking the shit out of all of our leftover food, well, Paulie Mac is. We're going to have the big bonfire and ceremonially burn all the unnecessary crap that we've accumulated and don't need or hate or want to get rid of. So it's going to be a hell of a good night.
Let's burn some shit.
Bring that little ass back here. Turn the camera. Turn around, little streaker.
All those in favour say aye, aye. Badly aye. Aye.
Cheers.
Yeah, go down, buddy.
He's just dropped that line.
No, I said all those in favour. Alright. All those in favour.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
What have you done, Paul McMillan?
I've thrown a butane canister on the fire.
Why would you do such a thing?
Shits and gigs.
swear she's destined for the screen. Closest thing to Michelle Pfeiffer that you've ever seen. Oh, lady.